All right, guys, welcome back. We're going to be doing a design review of the futuristic transport vehicle that you guys are working on right now, okay? So let's get in here and take a look. So I have a bunch of renders from different students, and the purpose of us doing these demos, or I should say these critique reviews, is just to go over some design basics and to try to solidify shapes and see how we might be able to enhance any ideas. So Peter, this is yours, right? You took the weirdest shot up, going looking up at it like that. I'd rather see it like from a side view.
I took three shots. Actually.
So I mean, what? The one thing I can't see, you did?
I did.
Oh, there it is. Ah, thank you. I couldn't see the side view. So, I think this is nice. I mean, I think this is working. You have a good.
I haven't really been able to work on it.
No excuses. Tell that to the unemployment line, right? So that's an interesting shape right there that's counting over. I think something you could maybe think about is if this back shape arches up a little bit like this, and maybe you have a larger tire in the back, and then these become a little bit smaller. Not smaller, they could even be the same size, but you create a little bit of contrast between the two. And you'll see that type of shape language, it's very popular in tractor designs. And a lot of that's because of torque. So when you look at like a Caterpillar, right, you have a huge rear axle that's giant. Does that make sense? Because that creates the torque. So the gearing is geared so that you could even make this come down to like a smaller one in here. And then you could do something with those. But I would just, from a thought and standpoint, these all being the same. So it could work too. But once you get the tires up there and you get it, when you're looking at it, are you going to go tires or tread, like tank tread? I want you to have part of the project brief was to have, you have to have a tread in there because I want you to have to model a tread.
The front I have kind of like a tread. It's like, it's kind of weird. Like if you pull up the other shot, I think it might be like not the bottom of the mount. You can kind of see it there, but I think you can see it better on that one, on that shot. Where I kind of have the center.
Uh-huh.
But then like the exterior just kind of.
You're just going to have to get that to come down. It's going to have to feel like a definite. I mean, if that's a tire tread, get the rim in there, everything else, get it, you know.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not sensing that. This feels really nice from a front view. How you have this sort of, you know, that angular shape that's in here. And then these are, you know, these large elements that are out on the side. I think that gives it a good visual weight. And I like this idea of the back view. I think that adds a lot of strength of having a single wheel back here. And then having, you know, these two large components there. I think that does a lot. So that actually changes part of what I was saying here because I didn't realize this was.
So
this is a lot thicker. It's one center wheel in the back. And you know what? Because of that, maybe this is on some type of a pivot system. Maybe that wheel, because maybe you know how you steer a tricycle from the front?
Yeah.
And it's a single wheel. Imagine if you drove the tricycle backwards, you'd be steering from the back end, right? Maybe these change a little bit too, but you could consider having some type of a large turret base. Okay. Well, I would definitely do that. And still, if you enlarge this size a little bit, think of this as that rear, you know, it's just like on a dragster, big, thick tires in the back, you know. So if you enlarge this a little bit, this is the back end of your transport vehicle, all the torque that's pushing and driving, and then this is steering over it. Another thing that I would recommend, too, is give this some type of really nice heavy-duty hydraulic linkage and arm suspension in here. So you might be able to raise. So imagine this vehicle, look from a side view here or a front view. Imagine this vehicle going over terrain like this. One side of the tread might pop up really high while the center mass of the body stays down low. And then the other tread's here. Like what? Yeah, but I'm thinking even more than that. I'm thinking find a way to make a good example is a trophy truck. A trophy race truck has these huge suspension links that sometimes even come out of part of the car, enabling the car to always have grip on the ground. So imagine if this is from a front view going over all types of terrain like this. This one could maybe raise quite a bit now and can stay lower. So I wouldn't just attach this into the body and have it permanently. I would definitely have a very defined suspension system in there that'll give it a lot of feel. But what I do like is that there's sort of a cool feel starting to develop there. But some of these feel very similar. the treads in there. Just look at it. Make sure it feels like, look at a mud terrain tire. I mean, this is a rear tire. You don't want it to slip. You want it to have a lot of grip. I like the word gription. My wife says it's not a word, but it is. It's the act of gripping. So you want these tires to have, you know, just this really pronounced shape. And what I call it, those are knobbies, okay? Really pronounced knobbies that perhaps come out. That way it could drive this thing up a building. Excuse me, not a building, up a large hill. Or, I mean, it could drive it through a building type of thing. Just right now, some of these are just barely pronounced. So imagine if this is in the desert, it rains, and it has to go up a hill, those are just going to spin. Really grab some of those knobbies and get them to pop out. This is nice, too. I like this. You have some cool shape language taking place in there. So I think that's on its way. Yeah, I think it's on its way. You get the suspension in there. I think that'll be really nice. Keep in an idea. I would not have that front. If that's like the canopy or the driver's spot, that's huge and sort of it sort of kills the scale relationship in there. If you have this a little bit smaller or a little bit detailed with like lights in the front and there's a smaller area. No, I understand, but just keep the scale.
Yeah.
Don't go too large with the window is all I'm trying to say. You can do whatever else you want.
Gonna start putting the window on, but that's not the window yet.
Okay. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and close this then. Any other questions? Nope, so you're on a good direction, just keep it going. And let's take a look at who's next here. Okay, next we have David Doe.
Yep.
Is that the only one you have, Dave? That image?
Yes.
Okay, cool. So you are putting wheels on this, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is just body shape.
Yeah.
I would have put even just a rough cylinder in for the wheels, because
okay.
It'll give us an idea for scale. Like, for example,
right.
When I'm looking at this, I don't know if you're imagining, you know, oh, that's the rear view. What am I doing? For a minute, I thought that was a side view. That's the rear view? Huh. Anyway, I'm trying to imagine. Oh, it's like a rear three-quarter maybe?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought it was a orthographic rear. I'm like, wait, I don't get the. Now I see the center line going down there. That makes sense. So I'm looking at the front here. I'm just imagining this really cool sort of. You have lots of nice angles in there. I mean, you could do. You could have a mix where you could have like this really cool angled tread and there could be a series of wheels.
That's what I was thinking.
Is that what the drag? Okay. Or, you know, again, it doesn't have to be necessarily angled tread. It could also be, you know, just if you do go for a wheel, I definitely have a large and then maybe go like to two smaller, like something like that, that gives it a real, you know, that large rear wheel does so much. I mean, we look at a lot of the contemporary or the current bikes, like the, you know, the, what's that show where they make the bikes in New York? Orange County Choppers, yeah. When you look at that show, you look at those big fat tires,
yeah.
And you look at, you know, go look, I just saw a neighbor down the street, he's got a new Porsche, big fat tires in the Porsche, skinnier ones up in the front. You look at old dragsters, old muscle cars. That's just a common theme you're going to see all the time. So exaggerating part of that tire size, whether you decide to go round tire or you go angled, you know, tank tread pattern. Just don't make it symmetrical like this.
Right.
I would have it go sort of in one, one direction. Hold on, I thought I was on another layer and I'm not. Unless I deleted it by accident. Definitely go, you know, obtuse and acute. You might have something that comes in like this and then balances itself out like that. Does that make sense for your tread? With rounded edges, of course.
Yeah.
So it's not so, something like that can be pretty cool. And then you get the other, you know, but have it very beefy and heavy too to support. There's a lot of weight in the feel of that vehicle mass. You know what I mean? It's really nice. It's nicely done. And this really feels powerful to me too. Looking at this, you have lots of cool, you know, you got a cool center line coming off of here. You could get really cool lights and all kinds of grill details, a big Warren winch, you know, like the big mounted winch for like, you can get all that stuff in there. Now, I'm not getting necessarily a distinctive feel of this being necessarily military-ish. I think if you put weapons on it, it could be military-ish, but it doesn't have to be. It can be, you know, transport, you know, search type of vehicle, and I think that would work just fine as well. Okay? All right, good job. Looks good. It's good blocking. All right. Hung. Look at Hung is killing it. It's like, I'm done. I'm finished. Right? Did he cheat? One of his old vehicles?
I use old parts.
That's not cheating. That's modeling smart. You guys that have had me for a couple of years, that's reusing your parts. If you can reuse your parts and save yourself time, oh my gosh, that's the one gray area in the industry that's never really been sort of frowned upon or not really been looked upon, is that I have a bunch of models from like four different studios that I've done. So, you know, I actually can take a round planter from one studio and I can turn it and then take a tire tread from a vehicle, put it on it, and you would never know. You know what I mean? There's nothing wrong with reusing your parts and areas of your model. So, what is this little guy here, hung? You just throw it in there? Because I hope, don't tell me that's a motorcycle, because it's awfully wide to be like a motorcycle, you know? I have an idea for that. Since it looks like it has some type of tires in it, the idea that I thought could be cool is, what if you had some huge angled mining drill or something that's on the back of that vehicle, and when it goes like this and folds back and goes, it has this tire tread system on the back of it. So when it stops and it's about to work, it lowers this. And then maybe it has, you know, maybe you add on something that shoots these big bolts in the ground, and that acts as like a support. Or it could even be a turret support of some kind. You know, this vehicle could have, what were you imagining for the vehicle? Okay. Yeah, I think you could definitely get away with using that for something in regards to, you know. And you could also take it and tuck it up in here and have it more like in here as well. And maybe if that vehicle gets stuck, this huge thing presses itself, you know, downward like this, and that helps elevate the vehicle off of whatever it's stuck on. Does that make sense? You could do something like that. So, I mean, you have lots of little options here. I think this is really nice. You divided these shapes really, really nicely. You have the shape language, I think, is really quite handsome. It works well. You have this cool element here. It's connected here. Then you have this other shape that's here. Make sure this distance from here to here isn't quite the same as that. We're getting a little similar, but then you separate this other element in here, and I think that adds a lot. Yeah, end up having a couple different shapes that look totally different. I think the tires look really cool, so you could have fun with those, or you can add to it. I really like the rim detail on there. Definitely make sure that this looks like this element in here. What's going on? I'm drawing on it. Hold on, I lost my red. Make sure this element here is a cylinder-based connection system where it connects up. So if the front turns, the back, allowing this vehicle to turn through corners and stuff. And really take a look at maybe like a train, how trains connect and hook up. Also take a look at some of the big semis, how they hook up, and make sure it has that feel. So the front mass, so basically from a top view, you want your vehicle to feel like it could do that. And that'd be cool to pose it too. It's like slightly turned like that. Okay, and you could have that in there. And I definitely, for some reason, you know, when I'm looking at this vehicle, there's just a lot of mass and brute power coming from the front of this. I really like the idea of you considering, since you're a little further ahead than everybody else, considering making some type of huge either trailer or attachment to this, which is the mining equipment. Okay. You know, or maybe like, you know what show I had? Remember Armageddon? And they had those like cars that they had to land and they had to mine with. I didn't like the cars as much, but I liked the mining gear, and they had like these huge plates that came out and they would like shoot, you know, big rods into the ground to hold it steady. And think about that type of system where maybe it pulls up and this back trailer of parts, this huge monolithic like shaped element that looks like a drilling mine, it's going to have little arms that come out and mount itself to the ground and everything like that, you know, hold itself steady. Okay, all right, good job. It's very nice. Just please tell me these aren't road bikes.
No, they're not.
Okay, good, that's all. Okay, very nice. It's going to be a lot of fun. All right. Excellent. I mean, that's great for a blocking stage, you know. All right. And Molly. Yep. So we got two views here.
Oh, that's my tire.
That's tire tread? That looks just like a Michelin tire I would put on my car.
Oh.
It looks very similar to like a standard tire. Good. Okay, that could look sweet on here if they're really large, you know? Get them really large in size. So I like this. I think you're on a good path with this. When I first looked at it, I really liked the brute feel of what you have in here, these angles that are like it just could like demolish over rock. And I mean, you have this little protective. I might consider bringing part of a protective plate over the edge right here, covering a little bit of these wheels. Maybe you end up having some type of a, not necessarily gears, but little mechanisms or little parts that connect in here somehow. They might be hydraulics that control how the wheels push and move going on a horizontal aspect. Does that make sense? Some of the big tractors that I've seen by Caterpillar have little hydraulics in there so they can pull the wheels or stretch them out at different angles depending on the hills that they're climbing. So you could, you know, have some type of mechanical machinery in there. This is cool in here. Avoid 90s. We have a straight 90, sort of similar to a 90 in there. I would... That's okay. You could, even if you did something like this, where you just came in like that, you know, where you have a line that's going across here, something here, and then maybe that even angles off a little differently forward, and then maybe it comes back a little like that, you know? Just anything to, and then you can, you know, don't have the same space variation, have some variation in it, but, you know, or you could decide to maybe just keep this straight and put like a huge grill in there that's like very protective, and there's maybe it's an intake valve to cool the engine or something, whatever you want to do. I mean, you got a couple options. The one thing that I would probably recommend to you, let me go back a couple steps. Actually, I don't think I can go back too many. Let's see. So the one thing I would recommend to you, sorry I didn't put another layer above this, is this top shape. I would find a way to raise a teeny bit and get it to break the body shape. Does that make sense? Because right now you have this. You have one like large, like rhombus looking type of shape. Does that make sense? If you get the silhouette to do this a little bit, where the body's here, and then maybe this raises a little bit, and then, so there's a little bit of space between here and here, then you have this really massive upper shape in there, it's going to enhance. So then you come back down in here and there's a little bit of a gap where it drops. And then, you know, there could be other mechanics back here, hydraulics, but by raising it up, what I'm doing is I'm trying to enhance the visual silhouette shape and read of it. So I'm trying to get the more lineage or line control to go around there, because if I break that out, it's going to do more for the part of the silhouette. Okay?
Yeah.
Unless you decide to keep this connecting to here, but then I would put another element on here somehow, maybe comes forward again to enhance. We want to avoid working on a cube, you know?
Yeah.
Just really get the eye to get an interesting silhouette for the eye to go around, you know, whether it's lots of curves, little bumps, something that might protrude forward, then it comes all the way back, then it drops down and goes. That way we just get it to be, you know, the better the silhouette, the more interesting the object's going to be. Okay, so just be careful. I mean, I'm just worried about this because it has a little bit of you know what I mean?
Well, it'll be
rounded
when it's
done. Now that's another option, is if you get in there and then you really round something very cool in there and have it very futuristic style or feel to it, that could also change part of the feel to it, okay? All right, looks good. I like the three wheels on it. I think that looks nice. Where are you gonna position those? Okay. All right, on your tires. Your tires look a little like this. They look a little round.
Yeah, I
got a flat. Yeah, all I was gonna say is that when you get into that vehicle, the weight of that vehicle gives me that feel of the tire being sort of like this, maybe curved a little, and then it's sort of just like, it's just wide. It's made to like run over small women and children. No, I'm just kidding. I want to see if anyone's paying attention. It's made to like roll over rocks and heavy items and has a weight. When you get this type of roundness, too much of that roundness in it, it's going to make it feel sort of like a little Honda Civic tire, you know? So I'd really stretch that design element there. Okay, good job. Very nice. It's good blocking. I'm telling you, that feels like a Bridgestone, and that rim looks like a, you know, like a little empty rim or a little decorative, you know. But it could really work on the vehicle once you get this weight and feel to this going all the way over and have it feel like a big, heavy, massive tire. Also, you could consider on a lot of all-terrain tires, they have on the sidewalls here, they have little knobbies that sort of pop out that help grip, especially if it's going up a hill or running into something. You could add some of that to it. That'll definitely place a more aggressive look and feel to the design. Okay? All right, very nice. Okay, and Hung, that was your reference. Yeah, good. I'm glad you put their reference page in here. Yeah, see what I was saying about the large tire? See here? See that large tire there, large? It's like, that's just so typical. If we were to bring up Caterpillar tractors and start looking, you're going to see a lot of the gearing set around rear wheel and that just huge axle loaded tires. I mean, I like this design here, but the one thing that I battle with is that they're all like the same size, and I just love having size variation. I think it adds a lot to the design. Even this. Now, Molly, I think this could work on your design. See how this, it's up here. It doesn't separate from the body, but there's lots of little intricate details to get that silhouette to keep reading and moving. See that? This one here on the top left?
Oh, yeah.
See how I just drew on top of it there?
Uh-huh.
See how that is? This is part of the body, very similar to your design. Okay, but see how there's like, you know, there's this part that comes up. There's something there. There's a little like thermostat there. There's a light. There's another light. There's the window canopy, a lower section, a big heavy like skid plate. Then this whole front thing that's like a divider or like a cow pusher. You guys know what cow pushers are?
No.
That thing on the front of a train. The black iron thing that's like this, shaped like a triangle. That's called a cow pusher.
Dark.
Huh?
Dark.
That's what it's for. If a cow is on the track when the train's coming, it like, if it gets caught under the wheels, it could derail the train. So that cow pusher literally like smacks the cow and probably kills it and then knocks it to the side and prevents the train from running over and whatever. But that's, my grandfather worked on the Rock Island Express Railroad in the Midwest. So that's what a cow pusher is, okay? All right, this is cool too. I like how they put this huge, that's a good, when you look at that, the diesel impact. That's something we didn't address yet that I thought of talking about with you. It's a good thing to maybe cover now, looking at the reference that Hung has, okay? Is thinking about how your vehicle's powered. So if this is a gas-powered vehicle, right? Can anyone here do an imitation of a diesel for me?
No.
Come on. No one? Can you do the imitation of a little Honda? Or how about my little Hyundai I use for commuting? It's like, it's super easy, right? Have you ever heard of diesel? People put those big smokestacks on, it's like, you know what I mean? It's just it's this huge, deep, bassy sound, right? Think about that in your vehicle. If you consider that, that's something to place in consideration. How is it powered? Is it nuclear power cells? Does it make a, like it's powering up, and maybe there's a light that glows? See how that light connects to the power source? Versus if it's a diesel, what do diesel tankers have? Come on. You guys are in my land. Focus. What do they have? Huge-ass gas tanks. They have giant gas tanks on the side. Look at this thing. Look at this thing plowing smoke here. Look at the size of those gas tanks right there. They're enormous. Okay. Have you ever seen the old Sherman tanks? Seen what? You've never? Gosh, you guys get out at all? Have you ever been to a museum and seen any of the old historical battle tanks or Sherman tanks? They're like these massive wide tanks, and the whole back end part of it is just one giant gas tank. Because when that thing starts up, it's like, and then it's just like all this black smoke filling everywhere. It's this huge diesel engine. Diesel engines have a lot of torque, a lot of power. That's why truck drivers usually drive diesel, and why Honda Priuses are not diesel. Okay. However, they've now been able to convert diesel technology to where you get more gas mileage than you do with a gas. But anyway, that's a whole different story. So what I'm going for is, does this truck look like it runs on diesel? No. That truck, this design here looks like it runs on jet fuel, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Look at this huge engine back here. Look at all these pipes and connecting. There's a design emphasis in there. It's not just the body and the style that you guys need to think about. It's also placing consideration upon what, how is this vehicle powered? Look at this guy. Does that feel like it runs on diesel fuel?
No,
it has glowing blue lights in the middle. And it has this little part that opens. So if I had to give, okay, let's play a little game here. If you pulled up to a gas station, what would be the sound of the driver of this vehicle? Yeah, of this vehicle. What would he say to the gas attendant if he got out of his vehicle? So if I pulled up on that vehicle, and I pulled up to a gas station, and I got out of there, if I drove that vehicle, I'd say, do you guys have any 291 diesel fuel? All right? If I was driving this vehicle, I might pull up, and I'd get out, and I'd be like, do you guys have any titanium RX power shells? I need it, right? Okay, do you understand what I'm getting at here? What's the design language that's transferring into the drawing? What about that one right there? I might pull up to like a airport and be like, do you guys have any airplane fuel? My beast here runs on airplane fuel with this built-in jet engine in the back. Look at that jet engine in the back. Or rocket fuel. Okay. And when you look at this beast, that thing there, that's the same design choice for this guy here. That guy doesn't run on power cells. That thing runs on maybe like, you know, or not just diesel, but could run on some type of really thick, sludgy fuel. Okay, so incorporate that. Think about that. Look at this guy right here. What is that? Heavy transport cargo. That guy would pull up at a gas station and he'd be like, do you guys have a charge station? Right? That looks like he pulls out this huge cord and charges it into a wall and sits there. And they hit a button and like, whoosh, and the whole machine charges up. Because it's futuristic, right? Think about that in your design. What is your vehicle? I mean, that communicates through that design. It's very futuristic. Look at that thing. That thing to me looks like it runs off of some type of giant nuclear energy generator of some kind, right? Could be a like blue plasma. Blue plasma generator, right? Okay. Enough power to charge up this weapon platform or whatever it is in the front there. Okay. All right. So there's lots of available reference there, right, to talk about in terms of that. Good job putting that up because it made me think about that. And that's something I really, today I was just going to critique your shapes. And now we were able to, Hung gets an A, everyone else gets a D. No, we're just going to talk about shapes of the vehicle, but now we're able to divert a little bit into another subject matter, which is how is the vehicle being powered, which I was going to address that a little bit later when we get to the detail, but not a bad idea to think about it now. Okay. All right. Uh-oh. I lost all my tools again. I don't know what I did. All right. Give me a second. Let's load the other video or the other images. All right. Just started the recorder again. Okay. Let's take a look at Anthony's vehicle here. So great reference here from Anthony, right? Look at that. Look at those tires. Look at that brute vehicle. Look at the shielding on there. What is that? What's the voice you'd say? Come on, Kylie, give me a voice. If you're driving that.
Oh, man.
No, that's good. Yeah. That's good. But what would you say to fuel it? Look at that blue power cell there, right?
Do
you guys have any R7 lithium crystals?
Yeah, there you go.
Right. So, you know, that's what you'd say to fuel that, you know? You're not going to pull in and be like, hey, you guys got diesel? You know, no. You're going to, you know, that's, look at how that design, how that incorporates, and I like how they incorporated that back into here as well. Okay. Anyway, these are great. There's lots of good reference in here. I like the tires. Look at the design. Look at the way they're breaking down the shapes in here. Those of you that had me in the digital drawing class were talking about division of space and creating lots of fun, interesting angles in our design. So that looks very cool. That's nice. Look at those big knobby treads on there. Okay, look at that, like, sort of jet engine. Perspective's a little weird on that, but not bad. Nice reference, really good job. Okay, I've seen that vehicle before, too. I think it's funny, it says fire, but it feels like there's a machine gun on there. Maybe it shoots out foam. I don't know. Anyway. There it is. There's another shot. Look at that, you guys. When we talk about detail, look at how nice. Look at these design elements in here. Look at, see how you see the shocks in here. You have the lights there. There's the Warren Wench. Another set of lights. Those might be like high beams. It might be wide angle lenses here. That you got to think about that detail. I told you guys I have a little buggy. It's called a Razor, Polaris Razor, right? I have three sets of lights on it. I have a light bar that's an LED light bar. I have another pair of LEDs that are square, that are a narrow beam that shoot further and or farther in distance. And then I have another set of lights, which are the standard lights that came with it, which are short, wide angle lens that don't go further than about, I don't know, I'd say 40 feet. Okay, so all those are, you know, pretty cool. Look at that. That's pretty awesome. Isn't that not just a G.I. Joe buggy or what? What if we could go buy one of those? It'd be really cool. Nice. Boy, look at that. Isn't that neat? That's a great design element. Look at, you know, how that rim comes together and is held by this area. And if you thought about putting that into your design, you keep the weight of the vehicle down if there's no rim inside the middle. So if you have an attachment system like this, then you have a large knobby tire like this, and then with no rim in the middle, that's all lightweight, and now it's just the tire going over the device. So that's something, that's an element you could take from there. Also, what I like is I love that exhaust coming out the back there like that. Okay, very cool. Nice reference. Anthony, do you not feel that influencing you a little bit?
Yeah.
Your design build? It's so important to pay attention to reference like that, okay? All right. Oh, look at that. Again, remember we talked about the hollowness? Look at those tires. Just simple, big, giant mud trains, right? Nothing too complex. Excellent. Really nice design. Very sleek. Very functional. Okay. That's pretty cool. Look at those tires, guys. Going a whole different direction. A big, round, like, sort of corkscrew. Look at those shapes in there. That's really interesting. That's a great design theory. This is what they, you know, they specialize in Art Center. Is just, you get in there and you spend a lot of time thinking and emphasizing. I know this is, you guys are here to junior college learning basics on design and model and modeling and stuff. But, you know, when you get one, I have a couple of friends that have gone to Art Center. I have students who go now. One of the things that they're really big on is, you know, product branding, is you take a current brand that already exists and you just remodify it and come up. You try to keep a lot of the design principles already there. So when you look at like John Deere or Caterpillar, it's maintaining some of those same principles, but then how do you expand out on it? So pretty cool. Hung, this is what I was talking about. See these right here? Those huge elements that come out from the side. So you get this massive like drilling element that would be on the back of your vehicle. And you know, maybe your vehicle could be like multifunctional, right? Sort of like something from Halo, where the back, there could be like a huge bed where you can mount in a weapon system, or you could mount in a mine drilling element with hydraulics and a cool arm like this. See, I mean, you could do all those different things, right? Into that. But look at the importance of this vehicle with those huge weight distribution elements to keep that. You know, when you go look at giant cranes. There are cranes on the back of semis, and they have those huge paddle weights that come down like this, because when those cranes start lifting objects from far away, they need that supportive weight. Those are other cool little elements to look at, okay? Very nice. I question the functionality of those tires. Were you wondering, like, if that thing starts driving, the tires all, you know, it looks cool, but how well does it work when it starts to drive forward? And does it spin? And then how does it wear down on one end? You know, so really good reference. There's some great elements in there to design from. Okay? All right, let's take a look at your vehicle.
It's just a simple block.
That's all right. That's all right. That's okay. You just find stuff in there that's working, and then you take it and you run with it, and stuff that's not working, you just ditch it, right? So on the tires, I think having that sort of square knobby, there's sort of 90s in it. Maybe think about placing some angles in there. so it feels like it can maybe dig in a little bit or adds a little, you know what I mean? Might modify, even if you did this, Tony, even if you had the tread go up and then down like that, it would feel better than having that 90 in there. I should just make it, I should put a little board in the back up there on the wall, and one of the things should be 90 degree angles kill all of design. There's just nothing really that are too interesting about some of those angles. Or sometimes they're great on mechs, but then, you know, having acute and obtuse angles, I really like what you're doing up in here. It's starting to feel very cool. Again, watch that 90. I maybe would angle this off a little bit, then maybe angle it back like this to wrap around the wheel. I'd put a slant on that so it's avoiding any of 90. So you're getting these cool angles that are in here that are being represented. Same thing when you get back here. I really like that a lot. I think that works very well. So does this. And then after you go across here, I would definitely just pull that corner out a little bit. Maybe you angle up and then you cut in a little, something like that, you know, just to keep enhancing that. And then also maybe it's not just that. You get to here and then you maybe you have another section that maybe even comes in and wraps around a little bit, almost like a fender or something over that. In fact, you could have, when you look at this point of view here, you could have a whole element that's like protective that comes over the tires a little like this. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's almost like a wheel well casing, but it could be very defined with like almost like armor plating from like an M1 Abrams tank or something like that.
Yeah,
you know, you could get that in there. Definitely like that approach of the large wheel in the back, smaller wheel in the front. I'm just sort of curious what would happen if you had extended this front forward, you had another wheel in here, and then you make this on a pivot system. Yeah, exactly. So the body can pivot, and then you could still have a massive canopy here like this, like a pod and everything, you know what I mean? But now the front system, see how it pivots? See how you have this cool overhang? So imagine you have this, what you have here, but then imagine if I come in here and draw this huge overhang like this. And then you have enough room from here to here for this thing to turn and pivot.
Yeah.
Add something different to it, you know?
I'll try.
Okay, you can throw that in there and see how that develops. And I sort of like this, I like these bars being overlapped on top of this, but then if this pivots, maybe this has to be linked to this back section. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So the bars come here, connect to this, and that comes down. And then this section is hooked up to the lower pivot, allowing the wheels, allowing that body to turn. There's something else to go for. It's just what I read out of the design. Okay, looks nice. Have fun. Take another look at it. Okay, any questions?
No?
Okay, cool. Excellent job on the reference.
It makes sense.
Yeah, some of you just in the beginning there, some of you didn't get any reference yet. That's okay. Look at this. X has a bunch of some really cool. Look at that. Is that, that's not M1 Abrams, is it?
I think it was Russian.
Oh, that looks Russian or Chinese, doesn't it? That doesn't look like an M1 Abrams tank. Look at how cool this is. Look at how this, I'm trying to draw on it and realize it's not in Photoshop. I'll have to point.
Yeah,
look at how this cannon has that shape that's on it, but when it goes back down, that mounts to the body. Isn't that bitchin'?
Yeah.
That's so cool to have that, like, it's like a interior puzzle shape that moves with it. You know, look at those angles in there. Those are just absolutely freaking awesome. Man, that tank sort of scares me a little bit. I haven't seen that design. I mean, that if I had a guess on that, I would really say that might be like a Chinese tank. It just looks totally different. It's like looking at, have you ever looked at Russian aircraft? Some of their military, I mean, look at some of the Russian MiGs, the new Russian MiGs. They look like something out of a space novel. I mean, they're really cool looking. Very nice, very interesting design. Let's flip through some of this stuff here. This is good stuff. Cool. I've actually driven one of those. It's a Citroen. It's powered by a 1.4 horsepower engine. It'll go, it's actually 1.4 horsepower. The gearing allow it to go 60 miles an hour. But if you drive by a truck in that thing, you could literally pick it up, pick up one side of the car. They're not that heavy. But anyway, just the whole thing shakes and rumbles as you go by. It's a good reference. That's cool. I love that big snorkel on there. Aha! Big snorkel on your vehicle in case it goes into water, right? Why not? Look at that light with the protective element on there. It's cool. Nice angles in there. Look at those other lights. Look at that bumper system.
Kind of like combine like, kind of like that kind of old style with like a military
crisp material. Absolutely. There's nothing wrong with doing that. That's what that is, right?
Yeah.
It's got a couple different styles in there combined. And this feels sort of hot rod-ish, you know? And then it also feels like a train with that huge mechanism there, you know? Yeah, look at that. Very cool. You got some good reference in there. Look at that grill. Wouldn't that be cool? Like a big grill like that on the front of there's an intake vent and that's part of the grill system blended into the body. That's great too, the controls. Mm-hmm. Okay. I like that, the Lego. Very nice. Good reference. Boy, that's a beautiful looking car, huh? Those are good designs. Yeah, that's great reference. You did a really good job on going out and collecting all this. Look at that. That's pretty cool. That is a giant cannon, though. That's almost like Liberace's cannon, sort of, you know. It's all detail, lion's head. Yeah, that's cool. Another interesting tank. Awesome. Good stuff in there. Okay. Really good. Let's go back here. All right. Cool. So tell us again, you're going for, just so everyone else knows, steampunk type of, what was your theme on this?
For your, steampunk, like, I guess I was like, kind of like steampunk futuristic.
Okay. I'm seeing that Mad Max sort of Borderland style in it.
Yeah.
I think you're starting to leave part of the steampunk.
Yeah, that's why I kind of strayed away from
it. Yeah, it feels to me like you're leaving that just a little bit. However, though, it's also reminding me of old school California 1950s, 60s hot rod. With there used to be with a, you know, those big exhaust pipes hanging out the back type of thing.
Reminds me of Dr. Seuss.
Dr. Seuss?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think he has a similar type of vehicle to that. So I would really nail down exactly what it is you want to do. Because in the beginning, I talked a little bit, it was a little bit of steampunk, and now you're going a little bit more. I want to make sure you lock into the right genre on this and you stay consistent, right? We don't go too much to one side. So just really narrow it down and decide exactly what area. So if you're going to go Mad Max type of thing, is that what you mentioned, right?
Yeah.
If you decide to do that, I would be just, Mad Max is like numerous vehicles sort of put together,
yeah,
like a big jet engine, this, that, a different Ford front end from another manufacturer, wide tires, you know, just, I would have fun with it. You're getting a little fanciful in here. Look, you have some Tesla, you know, what do you call those things? Gosh, I can't think right now. Didn't really have lunch. Tesla coil, ioners. What the hell are those things? So the base, the round part, there's a name for them that emits the electrical energy back. Anyway, but they're Tesla coils. So That still makes us feel a little like a steam engine in there, just a little bit, you know what I mean? Or some type of electrical element. So I would just really finesse what you're doing in the design direction you're going to go into. And then definitely, you know, go in. Remember, this is supposed to be, I got to keep you in those guidelines of a transport vehicle, right? So make it feel in there. I just don't want you to get, you're starting to go on the pathway of going a little bit more towards like a, you know, I had an assignment in one of the prop design classes, which was to, you know, design a Tinkerbell fairy dust dispenser. This is going into that softness and round curves genre, so be careful with that. Don't go too much into that. It could be stylized, but think of it as being, you know, a trans. Maybe you got to think of a show that you like or an animated series or feature, and then you're designing a vehicle for one of those characters in that, okay? It could be that type of transport, too.
Yeah, I haven't really thought about what I want to do with the tires.
Yeah, just be careful of getting a lot of rounded edges in there, and you're sort of leaving that transport vehicle feel, and you're getting much more stylized with it.
Okay.
I just don't want you to go too far into one area where then there's no pathway of return. So find something that, a theme that matches up somehow with the direction that you're going. All right, good job, X. Okay, and next is Kylie here. Okay, let me pause, I need to. All right, welcome back. So Kylie, let's take a look at what you have. So my first read off of it, Kylie, is it reminds me of when I was in Sweden of their snow search vehicles that they have. Is that what you're going for? The when I first saw it, it just reminded me they have these really cool European designed snow search vehicles because there's a lot of skiing in Sweden and parts of, you know, Norway. And they have these really almost like a little hotel on wheel type of vehicle where you could have a huge medical bay in the back for transport, and then the front holds like, you know, 2 to 4 passengers, and then you could still transport people that might be, you know, injured. So that's the direction it's going into. I'm curious what would happen if we went another direction and added a little bit more to this. Yeah. So check this out. This was my idea. You have this, and imagine if I came back here and did this. And I added a whole back section onto that. Does that sort of make sense?
So that it was
almost like it's linked together, and like I mentioned before, it's a popular design theme is having a center mass that's like a link like this where it's all connected, like a, you know what I mean, like a cylinder system where it connects like a train sort of. It's, so it's one vehicle, but then it has this overhang sort of like this, and this other area has a larger wheel because more torque in the back, right? And then maybe back here you have like an emergency bay that opens up. And you have drivers that drive here, then if they had to, maybe they could abandon this, and then it has those huge supports that come down with those pads, and it holds up part of the vehicle type of thing, you know what I mean? You can go into some of that other, into that genre, okay? Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. I think what you have there is cool, but even if I take that back view, I almost want to come in here like this, put a space, and then go. And put like another smaller element, you know, on this. You know what I mean? I almost want to do that like the front is turning a little bit, and there's just another tread up here with a part that connects, and then maybe this is the back bay, and there's like a huge plus symbol here. You know, and it's just, that's just another idea. I would maybe explore some of those. So I think this is a good start, but it just feels like something I've seen in Sweden, right?
Yeah.
And part of what we're going for is that futuristic. So I think what you could do is almost just duplicate part of that element and just see what happens if you come over here and attach something behind this.
I love the idea of having a medical bay in the back.
man, that's like a medical attachment, and that's,
right,
like,
and that's like what pulls
that way you can almost pull up, drop the medical bay, you know, and then it could also then take off and go out and help other people type of thing.
Yeah.
Okay? All right, very cool. So that was good. You came up with another idea and another direction to go with. And I think that really works, like when you're looking at here, look at what it just does for the silhouette. It's like one and then two, you know, so absolutely. Okay, very good. All right, let's see who's next here. Mark. I actually saw that in person. I was driving back home from camping on the 10 freeway, and there's a Warner Brothers truck next to me, and it had the freaking Batmobile on it. And it was so awesome. I was like, there must have been almost 10 accidents on the freeway because everybody was like staring at this. I mean, it was so, it had a huge wide load sign on it, and the back tires of the Batmobile were like hanging 3 feet off in each direction of the truck because that thing is so wide on the back of a big semi. I think that's a fun idea to look at. Okay. That's also very cool. Nice angles in there. Who is it I was talking to earlier about the suspension? Look at that beefy suspension in there, guys. Something to really consider about. As having a transport / off-road vehicle, you might need to have, look at that weighted bar. That's part of the chassis. So inside your any off-road vehicle, you have the frame. You're going to have this huge, thick metal bar for the frame. It could be aluminum, another metal. Look, and then you have a shock system in here mounted up. You have down here what we call A arms that are in the shape of an A, right, that mount here and here. You have, this is the four-wheel drive mechanism, so if your vehicle's four-wheel drive, it has this I forget what they call it, but it's the center rod that goes back that turns that wheel. So this connects to up to a four-wheel drive axle system. It's being turned by the main transmission, so that rod goes all the way from here, and then it turns the ones that go into these wheels as well. So you're going to have, so do you see all that? All of that information, this individual just didn't say, oh, I'm just going to make a vehicle. He went and he researched looking at vehicles. He researched the suspension, looking at four-wheel drive vehicles. There are specifics there for a four-wheel drive vehicle that you just not create out of your mind. Luckily, since I do a lot of four-wheel activities and camping and razors and all that stuff, that's very similar to what my little buggy has, just not as beefy and thick, okay? So something to think about, looking at those type of four-wheel drive mechanisms and what you might find, incorporating some of that suspension and shock mechanisms into your own designs. Okay, very nice, Mark. That's a good reference. Okay, so looking at what you have here, it has a very similar feel, a little bit, Mark, to the Batmobile. You can see part of your influence in there. I would keep going with it, and just keep what catches my eye is I really have some really cool angled shapes in here that I think work well. I like this sort of overlap here that makes it feel like it can climb and perhaps maneuver over other vehicles. I'm sort of curious what would happen if you just took this back section and duplicated another one and had this go over and you had another wheel like right in here. Would that really just modify part of the design? In fact, I can do that really quick in Photoshop here. Let me just double click on it. I can just take this. I can't. Hold on, I'm gonna have to erase it in there real quick because I don't have it on that layer selection. So if I got it in about there and make it a little bit smaller, perspective's changing. Okay, and then if I come back in here and imagine, I know it's a really cheesy paste job, but see what I just did there by putting that on. And then perhaps this body comes all the way back a little bit more here. And the reason why I wanted to do that So I feel like it gave me a little bit more visual weight now. This looks like a very heavy area to hold some type of a really cool, badass mining turret, whatever. You know what I mean? Because we have double sets of wheels back there. Same principle in a semi-truck where all the load is hanging the most. That's why they tend to have two axles in the back, you know, these huge tires to accommodate that weight. So I sort of like that idea, just branching off of what you already had. Okay? Just going in there and doing something like that. Your choice. I just feel like that adds more weight to it, gives it more stability, and makes it heavier looking. Okay? I would definitely, when you get into that turret, really design up a really cool looking turret. And the other thing here that I want you to be very careful with is that cockpit. That cockpit right now, you got to think of scale. It's making me feel like that's almost for one driver. Okay? If you consider doing this, if you consider the scale, if you consider that, look, maybe just this part of the cockpit is really the cockpit. And maybe the scale of somebody to this is that. That makes that vehicle feel massive. So imagine that rear wheel here, and then think of that as the scale versus instead of the scale being like this. See the difference? Because if this, like that, it's actually the scale is probably, if this was the whole cockpit, I'm imagining a head, a body sitting in here, somebody might be about that tall getting into the vehicle. One of the things you notice about good designs is a lot of time is just not the angle, the curve, the breaking of the shapes, the silhouettes, but also the scale issue. So having scale look very small makes that vehicle look very large and very powerful. Okay? All right. Cool. Yeah, it looks great. Just whatever, in the end, don't do a half dome. You could do a half dome. Just put lots of detail all over it and break it up with protective pads and all that type of stuff on it, make it look very cool. But I think you're on to a good direction. Okay? All right, cool. Nice work. Good blocking. All right, and Mr. Kim. All right, let me pause here. Yeah, Paul? Huh? You always say that in my classes. I don't like it. Let me tell you pros and cons, right? Hey, Mark, remember just talking about scale? Look at that. See that little cockpit? Look at the scale of that, how massive that cockpit makes that vehicle feel. It's a good example of that. This is cool, too. Good reference, Paul. So I think you're on the right path. Just be careful you don't turn it into a tractor. Okay? It has very similar aspects of a tractor. Tractors have very large rear wheels. They have very skinny front wheels, especially some of the old school tractors. Keep this going. Just add on to it and make it feel, if you're going for a menacing vehicle, make it feel menacing. What is this? Again, some of the basics we talked about today. How is your vehicle powered, right? Is it mining? Is it, what's it carrying? What kind of transport is it doing? It's also going to change part of the designs. Incorporate some of those elements into what you have. Does that make sense? That's all you got to do. Part of me, when I see that, that's funny. Look at that Suzuki Samurai right there. Is that that's not a Samurai. Look at that. How badass is that? Look at that vehicle. Isn't that cool? That's like real new. I've never seen that before. Is that real, Paul? Do you know? Just curious if that's just a prototype. Look at that. That's like a Humvee on steroids. Look at this huge. It's got a machine canopy. It looks like it has seating for like four or five in there. Huge wheels. That's awesome. That's pretty cool. That's a great piece of reference. Very cool. That feels like the Halo. Is that what it is? Yeah. That's what I thought. Boy, I'd love to drive that to school. When someone's like right in front of me, don't even need to honk the horn, just run over the back of their car. Little Hyundai with your little speakers in there. Okay, cool. Nice reference, Paul. Okay, good job. When I was looking at this, see if you have a side view. You have front, three quarters. One thing I thought about when I saw this is I like the tires in the back. I just felt like arching the vehicle a little bit more. Just, it feels like you have this height in here that's sort of going upward, you know? Just wondering what would happen from a side view if we had this. Well, you gave me two ideas. One was arching this so you have this cool midsection that might come up and gets arched, and then it comes back like that to the back, breaking that traditional like tractor feel, right? Then the other idea I had, Paul, is right now you're pursuing this as this is the front end. What if this was the front end? Does that make sense? Let me design it for you. What if this massive blocky shape is the front, and then the small wheels in the back are the back end? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
If I take the vehicle and flip it the other way, then it sort of looks like a angry tree jumping frog. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like it's spread out wider. What if the front is really wide tires, and then this is the back end? So what if you switch this vehicle out the other way and made this the front end and made that the back of the vehicle? Still keeping some type of arch in that design so it feels different, and then make this really like heavy in here. So this becomes the front, this becomes now the back. Flip it around and see what happens. Same thing like, you know, doing a concept painting. Flip the painting the opposite direction, take it in another point of view, and you end up getting a different feel to it, okay? Other than that, if you didn't flip it, I would say I think you're on a good direction, but I'm just curious to see. Just want to define. Right now, your silhouette is just doing this. That's it. I want to push the silhouette, you know, a little bit more. I want to get something out of it. That's why I was wondering if the front end was this really heavy, massive front end with lights on it and whatever and these huge wheels, and then the back end was a lot smaller type of thing. What would that look like? Yeah, flip it and then put lights on it and see what starts to happen. See what it starts to look like. Okay? All right, very cool. Nicely done. Just don't let it turn into a tractor. All right? And sorry, Mr. Arp, you're at the very end here. Very cool. Look at that, guys. Mako. Huh? No, of course, yeah. It's good. Look at that. Nice model. Look at the hung. We were just talking about the plates. Can you imagine that coming out the side to hold the vehicle down? I mean, that's awesome. Look at the weight and the power in there. It's really beefy. That's bitching. As we said in the 80s, that's rad. Okay, it's really cool. I love that. I mean, a lot of weight, a lot of power in there. That's a great little design. Could implement some of those elements all together. That's cool. Is that your tire?
That's my tire, yeah.
Okay. What kind of vehicle are you going for? Transport, right? I mean, similar to what we're doing.
Yeah, kind of.
Because for a minute here, this sort of started to feel like a stealthy, like right in that angle, looked like a stealthy off-road Volvo or something, you know?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Something like, I was kind of going to see what Mark was going for.
Okay.
I really like the Batmobile and the Warthog from Halo. But something with this, like a beefy suspension.
If you go that beefy suspension, I would recommend to maybe make those tires a little bit more nastier too.
Okay.
grab the surface of them and just pull them out a little bit more. Even you could do another extrusion and create lots of net. Like, that's a cool little pattern you got in there, by the way. Imagine grabbing that surface again and pulling out and extruding little knobbies.
Okay.
All along it. It would really have, also consider the width. If you add a little, make it a little bit wider, could add a little bit more of a heavier stance. Like that vehicle, if it's a transport vehicle. So whatever it's transporting, it might be able to hold more of because it's a wider based wheelbase. If you go really thin tire like that, you're on the verge of making it feel like it's a family transport vehicle, and we don't want to do that. You don't want to make it look like, you know, it's the Volvo S19 family sedan. You know, you don't want it to have that. You know, we want to go back to that futuristic transport feel. I think another way you can get that, Mr. Arp, too, is scale. If you make this beefy enough, what I mentioned to Mark, is imagine somebody standing right here like that big.
Okay.
And then imagine if this, like, canopies like that. That's the, you know what I mean? That's where the driver's sitting. Okay? It does a lot to change the scale. And again, like, it's just like in a drawing, scale can be your enemy. That if you were coming in here and going to tell me that this was the canopy, then that's a single man or maybe a two man vehicle, changes the scale and doesn't make it feel nearly as powerful. If you want to go for that powerful feeling, again, remember, if we bring up the class blog, right? Dart 106, right? Guidelines, futuristic transport vehicle, okay? So military, medical, mining, one of those two. Not family.
Okay.
Okay, keep it in that genre right there. Okay? Cool. I think it looks nice. Definitely the big beefy suspension, big springs in there. Got to look at suspension, look at sway bars, A-arm, well, your different type of suspension than A-arm, right, with those single arms like that, but maybe it has a multifunctional, like hydraulic shocks. It just, I'd just go nuts with it. Have a, just look at some good off-road vehicle, look at trophy, go on Google and type in trophy truck suspension. Look, there's some rear trophy truck suspension where like the shock comes out of the body itself. Have you ever seen those? The shock comes out of the body of the truck itself because there's so much shock room to absorb heavy impacts. That's something you can consider doing with this. What I mean by that is if I have a, let me see if I can get a side view in here. I don't really have the side view, but imagine a shock that's like connected here and then it cuts through a hole right here and the shock comes up, connects to something and then comes back down and connects to like another part down below here. See how that works?
Yeah.
Okay, so if I could probably just Google it real quick. Okay, so if I come over to Google and type in trophy truck. Sorry, I can't type today. Rear suspension. Look at the big A-arms, and you got these other steering stabilizers in here. There's lots of goodies in there. That's not what I was going for. I wanted to show you where it, like, really... Look at that. Look, guys, here's your answer to suspension right there. Okay? Trophy truck suspension. Look at that. Look at the roll bar cage. Look at that big suspension piece right there. Sometimes those come up out further outside the body, and they go past a little bit. I'm trying to find a good example of it. Look at that, there's suspension. Let's see how big this image is here. Doesn't have to be rear, let's just try suspension, see what happens. Images here. But look around, Mark. I get some of that reference. I think trophy trucks are a great way to start because you're going to find lots of really cool information. Look at that. I don't know if it's showing that's the way that huge suspension is connected on the back. See back here?
Yeah.
those part of the roll bar cage has these suspension canisters that are filled with compression that go back and they support this suspension right here. I would definitely have some type of heavy suspension in that vehicle. Look at that. That's some really cool reference too. Uh-oh. My gosh. Dude. So much for that. You guys didn't see that, did you? It's a naked lady on the front. Like, don't click that link right there. You'll get something else. It wasn't my, huh? You guys weren't paying attention, were you? Some of you guys are working in Maya. Good. It'll be in the video for like a second. You know? Why is it taking me to Woman's Health? There it is. Trophy truck suspension. Yeah, look at that. Look at those bars and those supports, those huge shocks. Don't hit that. Okay. Anyway, lots of good information there. Okay. So I would recommend getting some real beefy suspension in there that really makes that vehicle come alive. In fact, another thought is, what if you move the tires away a little bit from the body itself and had some type of really cool suspension contraption in there that makes it go like multiple ways? You know what I mean? Like, it's just, you're just adding more space. It just will make that feel like this very heavy vehicle. And if you do that and you control the scale relationship and make someone like that tall and make that vehicle feel very large, I think that'll really have a really heavy impact on what you're going for. Okay. All right. Very good. All right. My pleasure. All right. Good job, guys. And again, it's really cool. You guys, boy, what a difference looking at like the designs. You guys are really much more angular, obtuse, acute angles, breaking off of the 90s. That's great. So everyone in the class so far that submitted that, that's exactly what we want to do. That's the path we want to go down. And you guys are really moving into a good direction there. So a really nice pass at your first, you know, design mock-up for this. Now let's start to define it a little bit more, but really think about what we talked about today, just to wrap it up, right? Really identify. Some of you I asked a couple questions to and you didn't really know. Go back to the design brief that's on the blog. Look at, remember we said mining, we were very mining, military, very specific. How is your vehicle powered? If it's going to be diesel powered, it's going to have gas tanks. Is it going to be powered by jet fuel? It might have the impact of a jet engine. Is it going to be powered by blue tritium cells, or is it going to be powered by a nuclear reaction power pack? Make those decisions. Incorporate part of those elements into your design, okay? All right. Thanks, guys.